Welcome back to Assassin's Creed 3. It's been a while since we've done one of these. The main reason, I think, is mostly because of Horizon Zero Dawn and how fantastic that is. And I was like, do I want to spend my time playing that game, or do I want to play Assassin's Creed 3? And I think that Horizon Zero Dawn won in that situation because, who in their right mind would play Assassin's Creed 3 voluntarily? No one. So we're continuing. We're close to the end anyways, which is great news. And then I'll won't have to do this anymore. Because it takes a lot of time out of my day that I could be doing stuff that's more productive. And this is a bit shit. Well, I've spent the first 2 minutes of this video complaining, and it's only been 50 seconds, so I don't know how I've managed that. But so we are gonna finish this. Don't worry, it'll happen. Like, if this ever disappears again and it doesn't get uploaded for a little bit, just know it'll be back. Okay, I promise. Because everyone's like, "Where's Assassin's Creed 3? I can't believe you stopped it." And I'm like, "I haven't. It's still there. I just haven't done it in a bit." So that's that. And then also, because of Horizon, it's not just stopped this Let's Play a little bit and made it so that it doesn't come out as much. It's also a lot of other videos I just haven't been uploading because I'm too busy with Horizon. But it's worth it because it's great. And now I've had a great experience. But now we're back properly, all right? So just expect, until we're done with AC3 at least, 2 uploads a day. 3 p.m., 7 p.m., 3 p.m. be whatever. No, 3:30 p.m. and 7 p.m. is Assassin's Creed 3. And that's that. that's good news. It's good news. It's great. And what's the other thing I was going to say? I was going to say something else. Let's get a horse. Hold on. That should probably speed up this a little bit. So normal videos will resume with some more added stuff. So we're not just going to do Assassin's Creed unless there's news and we can talk about it and have a good time. Because I'm not just going to scrape the barrel of Assassin's Creed content, right? If I have a good idea, it'll happen. Which I have a few. I have a few ideas, right, regarding Assassin's Creed. I kind of want to spread them out. I don't want to upload them all in one go, but that's a thing. And then I have a bunch of videos coming out for other topics. And Shadow of War is a big one that I'm super excited about. So I'm excited to do, you know, some uploads on that. That'll be a good time. Oh, fucking shit. Where am I going? Is there a bridge? Oh, no. What a disaster. I'll have to jump in the water. So Shadow of War. I'll do some stuff on that, and that'll be a good time. I think a video of Shadow of War went out today. I'm actually recording this on Sunday, so just before I've done anything else. So I don't know if that's a thing. But Shadow of War video, I think, went out today at 3 p.m. So that's 3:30 p.m., which is great. Hope you enjoyed that. And then, also, the multiplayer battle came out today on patreon.com/asalways, where you can go and you can pledge your dollar and see it early. Or if you don't want to see it early, it comes out Wednesday. So there you go. There's that. And it's a good time. I hope everyone enjoys it. Or is enjoying the multiplayer battle so far, because it's a good time. If you haven't already watched the multiplayer battle, go and watch it. It's fucking great. How far away is this thing? I swear we've been going for ages. It's been like 3.5 minutes. Okay, now we're almost there. I probably could have fast traveled. Hold on. Could I? Oh, I could have fast traveled here. Oh, that's depressing. Shit. Wow. Oh, no. All right, well, at least we got that little bit of housekeeping out of the way, which I'm sure all of 2% if you listen to, which is great. Thanks so much. Appreciate it. With that, I want to know, because I feel like, I don't know, does anyone actually watch the entirety of these? So, like, you hear everything, or do you just skip through it? Because I feel like it's more likely be to, you know, skip through it, because I don't know, that's just the way I watch Let's Plays, because I'm like, I don't want to listen to everything. Like, I don't want to watch everything. Like, I just want to watch bits. And so I'm like, yeah, well, I'll watch this. And then, oh. Oh, we're getting close to the mission. I can feel it. And so let me know about that. But this will be the Abstergo section, because after this you come out the Animus. And Desmond's like, "Whoa, I gotta go to Abstergo." And that's really how he sounds. Hello, Lafayette. That's your name, right? Okay.
Connor, my friend. You have arrived just in time to bear witness to our glorious victory.
Where is Charles Lee?
That batard. He shows up in the middle of our preparations and just takes charge. Screams at everyone to advance, and then rises. I am left to pick up the pieces. they come from? Send word that we are falling back! Everyone, to me! Now! Now!
I will hold the area while you bring them to safety.
I grant you my finest soldiers to serve as your personal guard. There is nothing they will not do to ensure you are victorious. Bonne chance, mon ami.
It's alright. I know how to wield a cannon. Wait, do I? Because I've never used them before and I'm a native. Shit, maybe I don't. Maybe this was bad judgment.
We'll push these
I just have to stand here. Next to it, look pretty. That's just all I do. I don't actually ever fire the cannon. It's this guy that does it with his bent hat. Looks like, what's his name? From Red Dead Redemption. Williamson. Bill Williamson. Bill Williamson. Bill. Anyway, that's that guy. That's who he looks like with the hat and everything. Actually, they all have that hat. Some of these dudes that have, like, trying to pass it. This does not reload quick enough. Come on, like, fix it. Let's get on with this. We want to kill these guys. We also want to do it well. Like, this is not... Oh, my lord. Okay. Well, I'm afraid we're probably fucked at this point. But it's okay. Kill two platoons using a single cannonball. We'll try. Let's try these two. Go for it. I didn't do it, but we at least we give it a shot. Let's continue. Let's just keep trying. I don't know how I ever got that full save. I did it! Yeah! That was a mistake. At least I did it, though. Okay, let's try and get all the full sync so I don't have to come back and do it. I probably will never come back and do it. Actually, I'm playing this on PC, so I'll probably do it there. Because the game looks way better and it's more of a good time. Who bought it for me? I forget. It was a combination of Victor, Cryomaniac, and The Creed, Nick, bought me a bunch of Assassin's Creed games on PC. Like, Nick bought me fucking Assassin's Creed 3 as a joke. I know that. And then fucking Victor was like, he just gave me Brotherhood and 2 and, Black Flag? I forget. But I'm gonna play them. And then I bought Rogue for myself because I was like, I want to play Assassin's Creed Rogue on PC. I bet it's sound. Because, like, I always wanted Rogue to look prettier, because the resolution's really bad, and, like, it doesn't look as good as Black Flag. But I reckon Rogue looks as good as Black Flag on PC. Probably not quite as good, but, like, I bet it still looks pretty good. Which is, you know, I want to try it out, I want to see what it looks like. Especially 1080p 60, like, you know. We've got 30 seconds remaining of this. It's all good. Oh, there's one guy. Ah, oh, he's dead. It's all good. It's fine. We'll take out these two. Chill. Oh wow, that was fucking brutal. Yeah! 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, we did it! Whoa!
We are low on ammunition, sir, and the enemy advances.
Then we need to pull back, rejoin the others, and cover their escape.
I forgot this. This is a bit that happens. I completely forgot. Prevent Patriot executions. Oh, we've done the other full syncs. Oh, the frame rate is the... That's just ugly, isn't it? Oh, no. All right, let's prevent Patriot executions. Let's... Oh, Patriot execution happening here. No.
I will take care of this.
I prevented it. Like, does that not count? Oh, we did. I can just run away now. Screw it. Let's leave. Let's keep looking for more Patriot executions. I'll find them all. I think it's probably one over here, someone. Oh, what was that? Did I see a Patriot execution? No. Wait, what? Was that a... I think that was a Patriot execution. Run away, woman! Run away! I am stopping this Patriot execution. You're just looting him! This is not what I saved you for! To do illegal things! Stop it, you stupid woman! No! You look like that one from, Liberation. Like, every character from Liberation, they all look the same. It's not a racist joke, that's a game development is shit joke. What have I done? What the fuck is this? What's this? Are they homestead guys? Oh god, I didn't mean to start this. I didn't mean to skip this. I did not mean to do... What is going on? What have I done? I've just fucking messed everything up. What's happening? I didn't mean to do this. Oh god. She wasn't looting him. It was her husband. She was making sure it was okay. Are we just gonna... Oh no. What? What the fuck? What just fucking happened? Yep, run away. I finished the Patriot execution, stopped it from happening. No, these guys are just... Stop. Well, I outrun you, you stupid cunt, so it's fine. Alright, let's find some more Patriot executions. Is that a Patriot execution? No, that's just an army. Okay. Oh, Patriot execution! Run away! No! No! They executed him! Okay, screw it, we're not trying again. I'm just getting out of it. Nope! Okay. Well, now there's no point in even trying to do the Patriot executions anymore. We'll just fuck off. The frame rate is abysmal. I don't ever remember playing the game with this. Oh, no. That's like 12 frames. What the fuck was that? That's horrendous. Try fucking harder, though. Jesus Christ. Ayy.
Well done, my friend. You have saved many lives today.
Connor?
Charles Lee has betrayed you. He forced retreat in the midst of battle, hoping the loss would take the lives of your men and see you relieved of your command.
What?
I'm sure he will come and spin a tale saying that he was outnumbered or I was somehow to blame. All lies. I will say it one last time. That man is your enemy, and he will not stop until you are dead or dishonored.
Connor's tale rings true. Lee was acting most odd upon the battlefield.
I will investigate these allegations at once.
The time for that is long past.
This must be done properly, else we're no better than those we oppose. Never mind the political ramifications of such an act.
Should you choose to spare Lee's life, then I will take it myself. Enjoy your victory, Commander. It will be the last I deliver you.
I like that scene, because Connor knows that... I think it's a strange change, but, like, I get it that Connor would not kill George Washington, because he knows he's the best for the colonies, even if he doesn't like the man personally. Whereas Charles Lee, he would have killed him because, one, he's a Templar, two, thought he burned his village. So that gives him motive. When he learned that it was actually George Washington, he's like, shit. Well, can't stay friends with George Washington, can I? Because he burned down my village. But I can't kill him because he's the best thing for the colonies, and I care about the people of the colonies.
Something's happened, Desmond. Abstergo has your dad.
Abstergo is my dad.
Italy. Same place they were holding you.
What are you two waiting for? Let's go.
There's more.
Hello again, Mr. Miles. I hope this message finds you well, or as well as it can, all things considered. It appears we now each have something the other desires. I propose a trade. Bring me the apple, and I'll return your father to you no worse for the wear. Should you refuse, he will still be returned, albeit much worse for the wear. I assume you'd like to avoid an unpleasant outcome.
Why'd they take him to this? Italy?
Just not so soon. I wonder if Abstergo even knows what's about to happen. And has this been a part of their plan all along? Maybe they want the world to end. To see it all burned away. Then they'd have their new world, ripe for the reshaping. We talked about looking for another power source, leaving him there. It's probably what he'd want, for us to finish the mission. But I can't. It's hard enough taking a life, but letting one be taken? Knowing there was something I could do about it? Not a chance. Might be I'm risking my life, risking all our lives to save an asshole. What else am I supposed to do? That asshole is my dad.
Goddamn. Yeah, I don't know why they took William Miles to Italy. I don't really understand the, you know, purpose behind that. Vidic was like, we can't just leave. Yeah, we definitely don't have a facility in Cairo or anything. Like, you know, obviously not. Obviously, Abstergo, that worldwide organization, doesn't have a facility in Cairo, do they? Just, you know.
They know I'm here, Rebecca. There's no way they don't.
This was a bad idea.
You're a bad idea. Let's kill that guy. Why does Desmond wear his hidden blade on the wrong arm in this section? He's like, oh, because I've been in Connor's memories for a bit? Oh, now I'm going to forget everything I learned from Ezio, and I'm going to dual-wield things, and my bag is going to phase through my fucking hoodie. And my, fucking hidden blade's going to be on the wrong arm because I'm a stupid cunt, and I'm an idiot. Stupid piece of shit game. Doesn't make sense. Continuity errors really irritate me. Hello, pals.
Hand over your weapons and come with me, sir.
I can show myself in, but thanks for the offer.
I'd rather this not turn ugly, Mr. Miles.
Then let me through.
Subdue the subject, please.
I'm Desmond Miles. I now dual-wield weapons for some reason. Oh, I just realized why his hidden blade's on the other arm. I just fucking realized. Oh, that's really dumb. Because the left one is Connor's primary hidden blade, which is the swivel blade, right? So, and Connor's right hidden blade doesn't swivel. It's just a normal hidden blade. So, if they were to have Desmond wear the hidden blade on the left arm, they would have to reprogram animations to mean that the hidden blade would either... They'd have to make it so that it didn't swivel on the left side. But in this game, because Connor's hidden blade is on the right, on his left arm is the swivelly one, they had to switch it so that Desmond's normal hidden blade works as a normal hidden blade because it's Ezio's on his right arm, which would mean it works the same as Connor's. And then on the left arm, he uses a dagger, which is really just a reskin swivel blade. Like, that's what it is. And it's so retarded.
Fourth floor.
Well, see, you've learned absolutely nothing since you left us. Walking into an elevator in the middle of a hostile environment. Really?
Yes, really.
Where's my father?
You'll see him soon enough. Now be a good boy and wait for security to fetch you.
You're gonna have to climb the rest of the way.
Hatch. We're gonna do some Horizon Zero Dawn shit here, climbing through elevator shafts. Let's go, boy.
Need eyes on him.
Need eyes on you now.
Where the hell is he?
Yeah, he definitely couldn't see me there, though. See? He just swiveled out his fucking hidden blade! Okay. See? Because his fucking thing swivels! Look at that! Look at his fucking thing swiveling! Oh, it's so stupid!
That's okay.
When you press A, his like dagger that's meant to be a dagger, like the combat knife, fucking swivels in his hand like it's a swivel blade. Ubisoft, put more effort into your games, yeah? Just do two sets of fucking animations. Do separate animation with Desmond, just do it! It's not difficult, just fucking do it! Oh, God. Any other company would have done it. Any other company would have made two sets of animations. Ubisoft, though, no. More work? How dare you suggest more work? Never. Most minimal work possible is how Ubisoft does it. They cut corners wherever possible, and it makes all of their products pure garbage. Oh, okay then. Wow, what a really fun combat system that's not shit. Oh, wow. I know, this has already triggered something, but everyone's like, when's Assassin's Creed 3 coming back? I want to be angry at you again. All right, let's go into the room. Oh, fuck me. Can't go in there yet. Because for some reason, the Yubstergo's lock system works on this mechanism where if there's guards alive, it doesn't open. I just went through a fucking floor. Good. That's really good. Wow. Wow, that's actually incredible. Such a good fucking game. Anyway. I do like this bit, though, where you get to go into the room that you were in Abstergo in AC1. It's good. Good little throwback.
Give me the apple. Let's not draw this out. You got nowhere to go, and I've got a gun.
Yeah, you forget, in this universe, pistols in modern day take the same amount of time to shoot and reload as ones from the 17th century, so it's chill.
Knife for protection? It's stupid. All right, Desmond. Game's over. Not now. Not now. Inya is just a robot. Yet. Get out! What the hell was that?
Now that sounds like a really good idea, though. If I had a maniac that had, you know, schizophrenia problems because of the bleeding effect, I would definitely send him on important missions. That sounds like a really good idea. Wow, what an intelligent plan. I really love this, though. What is all this? I like how everything's all the same. It's cool. The laptop's still in there. Oh, you can't go in there. That's really disappointing. I do like this section. It's very good. No. You get back here, Cross. Get the fuck back here. Get back here. I'll stab you with my hidden blade that's on the wrong arm. I swear. God, the guns in this game sound abysmal. They're like... Like, that's just not how a gun sounds, though, is it? And don't say, oh, but they have a silencer on it. You realize silencers don't fucking work like that. What is the bag on Desmond's back? That's really good. Wow. Holy shit. Wow. I never had this issue before. I don't know why this has started happening, like, in Assassin's Creed 3 now. This never happened to me before. I don't know why in this particular playthrough, suddenly Desmond's bag is phasing through his back all the time. Or his back's phasing through his bag. There we go. Really good assassination. Holy shit. Whoa, one epic moment. Wow. Holy shit. That's it. Oh, man. Wow. Well, sick. Where's Vinny? Got his gun there. Fucking pea shooter. Let's do it, boy.
You killed him. Daniel was a son to me. A sickly son, perhaps, but one full of promise. Here you come.
This is well sick. Fucking love this gun.
And now you've taken him from me.
Look how Desmond's walking. The fuck is he doing? Desmond, what are you doing? Oh, God. God, wow, this is... Well, this is gameplay at its finest. Holy shit, I'm well pleased they did this. Whoa. You ready for this, Vidic? I'm coming for you, boy.
Dad? Not so fast, Mr. Miles. In case you hadn't noticed, I'm the one calling the shots. Now give me the apple.
You want it? Fine. Here it is.
Wait! No!
You know what this does, though, as well? It doesn't just pull the trigger and make everyone kill themselves. It also erases everything that Desmond held the apple. So it puts this weird idea in their heads. The Aguilar, this guy called Aguilar, held the apple last, apparently. That's canon. And I will, yeah, definitely is canon, 100%. That's what Desmond did here. It's got, you know, Alan Rickon. They all think Alan Rickon's into Rickon now. Desmond's just this troll. Like, he likes to just do this. He's fucking weird like that. Makes them all think Rickon sends Rickon for some reason.
You never should have come here. You put everything on the line.
Right, Rickon has this delusion about, you know, Aguilar. It's weird. It's all Desmond's fault. Fucking with their heads. Here we go, boy. This didn't happen, by the way. This isn't canon. Desmond didn't show that he had the apple and, you know, take out a whole Abstergo facility. That didn't happen. The last user to hold the apple is definitely Aguilar, 100%. This didn't happen. It's not real. It's all fake, made up. Bullshit. The movie's true. Aguilar is the last user of the apple. 100%. Sick boy. So much sarcasm.
I'd get the power source hooked up before heading back into the Animus. But it's your call.
Thanks, Dad. I feel like that's something you'd say. Alright, time to get... Let's put the power source in, then we'll get back in the Animus, I think. I mean, if that'll be the end of the episode. Like, if you don't want to watch me put the power source in, if you think that's a load of boring bollocks, which it is, you can just click off the video, because all I'm going to do is plug the power source in, and then I'm going to end the video. So, like, that's... Yeah, you don't really need to fucking watch that. And then next episode we'll do... Oh, fucking great. Next episode we'll do something that's not boring. Like this is... I mean, it wasn't boring at first when the game first came out, because it's super interesting, but now... Nah, it's not even relevant, so let's not play it again. Give me an option to skip it, please.
Or we were flesh, and flesh is frail. Though suits and shields might offer comfort, such adornments would not suffice. Not to save us all. So we sought to change what we were. In this manner, we might thrive in a world made poisonous. It was Aita who volunteered to see if it might be done. Aita, my husband, my love. In the end, it changed him, ruined him. He was made a prisoner of the machines. The body might survive, but his mind became brittle to the touch. He begged me for release, for days, for weeks, for months. I pleaded with him to give us time to find another way. But there wasn't one. Not for him. Not for us.
All right, let's continue onwards, finally. We're gonna get another one of those. I feel like we'll probably get like two more. Oh, wrong way. Top across. We go.
What is consciousness but a series of electrical impulses? And the body a vessel to hold these sparks. But it is weak. In time, it decays and crumbles into dust. We asked ourselves then, what if it might be replaced? with something stronger, something better. So we forged a new vessel, one that might endure. It proved easy enough to enter. But to leave required something more, something wrong. And so this too they abandoned. I wondered, though, were they right to turn away?
Oh, is it done? Oh, fucking hell, it's just on Twitter. Alright, where are we going next? Across here? Alright. Most of you probably skip over that section, anyway. So, you know, great. I have to sit and watch it, though, because I don't get the luxury of skipping those things, you know? You know? You know? You know? You know? You know? Alright, I think that's it. I think we did it. I think this is just it. Oh, thank God. Thank God. No! Oh, God, I thought we had another one. I got so scared. Alright, that's it. That's the last power source, too. So now we don't have to watch another one of those bullshit cutscenes ever again. Thank God. Jesus Christ. See, this is the kind of thing I'm saying. Like, those cutscenes are great. The first time you play through the game. Like, they're great. All the cutscenes are. They're fantastic. But there's some that I just want to be able to skip when I play the game again. Like, I don't need to watch those when I play the game again. I don't need to. Like, I understand the story at this point. Like, I don't need them because they're, like, those cutscenes, the reveal parts of the story. And it's like, but I've played the entire story, so I don't need them now. They're not relevant to me when I'm just trying to play the game. So, fuck off. All right. Here we go. Time to head back into the Animus and see what Connor's getting up to.